Hello, everybody. I'm super glad to join you here live for, I don't know, the first time this year. The last live that I did on this page was, it was a few months ago, so I apologize for that. As you know, I had announced it, and I want to do this live video to talk about top three qualities in sex. And for those of you who don't know me, well, I am a coach in somatic sexuality. And for 2 years, I've been doing this work physically in Bucharest, Romania, that's southeastern Europe. Although I've been doing a lot of work online as well. And this has been through YouTube, this has been through Facebook, recently through Udemy, and I'm super excited about that. So somebody shared a heart with me. I don't know who you are, but thank you for that. So as you know, I am super adamant about developing in sexuality, and not only in the classical way, so in an intimate relationship. Obviously, that's the first way that you're going to develop, and that's the first way you're going to, you know, cultivate top three qualities in sexuality. But there are other ways of doing this in a very ethical, constructive, and really responsible way, and that's through personal development or sexual development. So let's get into it. I see that I have three people. Hello, I don't know who you are, but I'm glad to have you here. So we're gonna get into it. The first quality that I'm going to put here, and I think it's the basic for anything, is presence. And when I'm talking about presence, I mean two things. First of all, presence in the relationship. So you're not thinking of former relationships, you are present in this relationship. And then presence, as in you're present to what is happening in the actual moments, and ideally in the intimate moments as well. So let me develop on those two. Presence in the relationship is when you enter a relationship and you're not thinking of former partners. And this is tough. I'm a human being. I'm not perfect. I'm not enlightened. I am just as, you know, anybody else. And I know how tough it is to stay present in a relationship, especially if you've had relationships in the past and you were maybe not okay with breaking up with that person, or you were really in love with that person. You were really functioning well from your perspective. So being present in another relationship is definitely a challenge. And from this perspective, my approach is don't go into relationships unless you're really done with your past. Unless you are really not thinking of how it was in intimacy with former partners, do other things. Develop yourself in other ways, dedicate your time and your energy to other projects. But if you can't be present in the present relationship, don't go into it. You know, wait, leave it for another time. And the second attribute of presence is obviously and actually presence in the actual moments. Now, it happens to many of us. You know, we're on social media, we're with work, we have to do a lot of things. And being present, not just in sexuality, but just being present in all the moments in relationship is pretty tough. And this is a quality that you cultivate with what? With meditation. Or with contemplation, if you don't want to call them meditation. Some people do prayer. Whatever gets you to focus on one point, and whatever gets you to focus on your present states, it can be dance, it can be yoga, it can be sometimes self-pleasuring. You've heard me in a lot of my videos, if you've watched them, if not, go to the video section. You've heard me talking about self-pleasuring in some of them, and how if anybody comes to do coaching with me, I will give them home assignments, and one home assignment, one of them, is actually to self-pleasure with an intention, with a time length, and with the drawing of conclusions afterwards. Was I present? What was happening in my body? That's the best way to cultivate presence in sexuality. And I think Woody Allen had this hello Paolo, nice to see you. So I think Woody Allen had this quote. He said that he's an excellent lover because he worked on himself so much. Now, you can think of anything from that perspective. You can also think of self-pleasuring in that way. It's a practice to get you focusing in a relationship. So this is the two ways in which presence is one of the top three qualities in sexuality. One is presence in the actual relationship, and the other one, presence in the intimate moments. Presence to what is happening, to what you're feeling, to what the other person needs, to what you need. Presence, or, you know, being there with the other person. The second quality is obviously communication. And when I'm talking about communication, I'm obviously talking about sexually related communication, and it can be verbal or it can also be nonverbal. And the nonverbal communication is of the master's level. And first, let's start with the communication at the verbal level. There are simple questions, you know, like the basic, the naive, the stupid questions sometimes, like, what are you into? What do you like? How is this for you? And a lot of people, when they hear these kinds of questions, they're like, oh, no, man, but that means I'm not confident. I mean, if I have to ask, then I'm not good at it, or I'm, you know, not self-confident enough, or I'm not charming enough, or whatever, good enough to, you know, make sure that the other person gets what they like. Not so. Not so. And if you've ever taken any training or class or retreat on sexuality, you will hear this. The mentioning of boundaries and consent. And actually, that implies, first of all, communication. What the other person likes, what they don't like. It means communication. About what? Sexuality. Or about touch. Or even about consent, about, you know, talking a certain subject. It can go down to that. Some people can have, you know, issues with various topics. So, first of all, it's verbal communication. And in a relationship, yeah, ideally, when everything's pinky in the beginning, you start asking questions, you know, what do they like? What's their ideal, you know, sexual moment? Or what's their fantasy? Fantasies are a huge source of inspiration if we ever get to, you know, if we ever got to talk about them. And I'm actually curious, how many of you talk in your relationships about your fantasies? How many of you have you asked your partners, especially in the beginning, like, what is, you know, that crazy thing that you dream of in sex? What is the ultimate sex moment for you? Did you ever do that? Was it easy for you if you did that? Like, was it easy for them to tell you? Was it easy for you to listen to them? By the way, communication is a lot about listening to the other person. And that means that you get out of your, you know, self and out of your comfort zone in a way, because you may hear things that are challenging to you. You may hear things that you actually might not like about you. And it's not easy, but I promise you, if you ever get into one communication, one conversation about sexuality, like one honest conversation with your partner, even if it's uncomfortable at a certain point, it's gonna get better. And the benefits on the long run are that you're actually gonna have a lot more insights into what your partner wants, into what you're doing great for them, and into what you could be doing even better for them. It pays off. Communication in sexuality is a top quality, and it pays off. And the nonverbal communication, and if you've been here long enough, you've heard me saying that it's the master's level. Yeah, well, that's, you know, translating the looks that they give you, the sounds that they make, the breath sometimes that you're hearing from them. Lack of breath also. Like, if it's a person that is usually holding their breath when they're super excited, for fear of, I don't know, not losing the moment or whatever other reason, then lack of breath sometimes, although it's not ideal, but still, lack of breath, if you can hear that lack of breath or that silence, that's also a sign. And it definitely takes a lot, you know, a deeper connection or just this super erotic and super high chemistry or electric connection with somebody to skip the words and get into nonverbal. And from my experience, in the trainings that I've done, we are encouraged to talk, like, you know, verbalize. And if not verbalize, make sounds. let the person know, you know, give them insights, if not clearly, what they're feeling or what we're feeling, and just, hi Roland, nice to see you. So nonverbal communication is not necessarily encouraged so much in the trainings that I've taken, and if you go there, but it is the master's level. So we're, Roland, by the way, if you've joined now, we're talking about the top three qualities in sexuality, and the first one was presence, and the second one is communication. So I was just done with that one. And the third quality is compatibility. Now, you're going to not like me on this one, because compatibility, first of all, means that you are, your body is learned or habituated to receive and offer pleasure in almost, if not identically, but almost the same way as your partner's. Now, learning the body's erotic language or erotic blueprint is an art, and a lot of people don't think about it. We know about the love languages, so how we need to communicate and be communicated love, but in sexuality, we're not yet accustomed to this, at least, you know, in terms of personal development. But this is something that I'm very keen on. And if you're lucky with compatibility as the top third quality in sex, you get a person that is in the same kind of receiving pleasure and giving pleasure, and they can take the same intensity, they can take the same length in time, sexuality, and they're not bored, they don't think, or it's not too fast for them, they don't feel anything. So if you're lucky, you get exactly that same kind of person. Now, if you're like most people, I'm here also, you may find people who have, or partners, who have a different language for, you know, understanding pleasure, a different route to arousal, a different route to orgasm than yours. And those are the most crazy-making relationships sometimes, because it actually implies that you work on finding out what is arousing to the other person, and finding out how you can work with doing something that may necessarily not be your first cue to arousal, but it is your partner's. And then they have to do the same effort as well. If they're in a different kind of blueprint, let's call it like that, then they need to connect with you and they need to make this effort. And not everybody does it. And what I've seen in the coaching that I'm doing with clients one-on-one or at events also sometimes, people who are of different sexuality languages, let's call them like that, they tend to reproach. So one of the two partners may be more dominant, and that partner tends to reproach and tends to impose their ways on the other person. And if the other person is not reacting, as in they're not aroused or they can't reach orgasm, then automatically they assume that is something wrong with them. And this is the... This is, by the way, this is a lack of quality number two, communication, because they don't check. They just assume that their way to arousal and to orgasm is universal. Maybe they've had partners in the past who were in the same pattern, and this present person is not like that, so automatically they're broken, there's something wrong with them, they're not sexual enough, their libido is low, and whatever. And this is mostly not the case. It's just that the sexual blueprints or the sexual languages are different for the two people. And if you're not lucky enough to be compatible, so this is quality number three, compatibility, then you have the excellent opportunity to work on it and to flex your sexual muscles in, first of all, the brain muscles to understand what is going on, what does this person want and what does this person need. Now, I'm curious. You don't have to write here, maybe it's too much for you, but I am so curious. What was the most rewarding sexual moment for you? And how many of these three qualities, presence, communication, and compatibility, were there from the beginning, or you actually had to work on them? So what was it? If you want to write, write. If you want to give me a private message, do that. I promise I'll answer those messages. And if you don't know now, think about it. So again, the three qualities, presence, and presence in the relationship or presence in the actual sexual and intimate moments. The second quality, communication, verbal and then nonverbal, the master's level. And the third one, compatibility, either as a given, if you were a lucky son of a gun, or something that was worked on. So you worked on it and you got to compatibility eventually. And the home assignment for you is to, you know, start to think a little bit about this or talk to your partner. Okay, how many of these do we have? How many of these do I have? And by the way, when you're asking that question, sit down, shut up, and listen as badly as you can. I mean, really listen. Even if you don't, hi Mircha, we're close to the end, but I hope you get to watch the replay also. So when you ask these questions, when you ask them, how many of the three qualities do I have? If you don't hear something that you like, shut up, cool it, don't take it personal, if you can, and try to take in that feedback. And try to lead the conversation in a very constructive way or in a constructive direction. Thank you, Janina. I hope it helps. And you get to watch it a lot after, you know, the live is over. And I'm curious what you think of this also. So, those are the toughest conversations, by the way. But again, the conversations, you know, top three qualities in sex, maybe they're not those. Like, by the way, I should have begun like this. My ideal top three qualities, because I'm the one that picked them, may not be yours or may not be your partner's. And that's totally fine. As long as you get to find out what their qualities are, fine, you're still having a constructive communication. So Roland says, knowing myself so that I can present myself, so that I can truly communicate what is in me. Yeah, so that's your number one quality, knowing yourself. Okay, yeah, absolutely. You can't, by the way, that's the foundation for everything. Foundation, you know, if you don't know yourself, you're putting a lot of pressure on your partner to for them to discover. And that's not exactly fair, that's not exactly helpful. And for some people, it's totally not sexy. Well, if you don't know yourself, how can I know you? Why should I know you if you're not doing your work? So this is it. I'm glad I had this live. Do let me know what you thought of it. And also, you can come back to this or send me a private message with your learnings afterwards. And if you want to find out more, by the way, I'm growing a group. And it's a group that I've affiliated with this page. It's called Vibrant Sexuality, and you can explore your vibrant sexuality. You can check that one out. You will see that the past discussions have been a lot in Romanian because I kept it with people who have been coming, you know, talking to me, have shown an interest in the people that I met live. But I'm about to change that. So if you're foreign and you get there, don't be discouraged. I will try, or I'll actually start talking English. And we can definitely keep up a conversation there. Or you'll be seeing more lives from me in the future, and you'll be seeing my weekly videos as well. So, this is it. I'm glad I was here. Have a beautiful weekend. Have a sexy weekend. Have an orgasmic or at least pleasurable weekend. And I'll see you in the next video, in the next live. Bye.